Ladies and gentlemen, our ceremony will begin momentarily. Today's ceremony is considered an outdoor ceremony, and all headgear is to be worn by all military personnel. We also ask that you please silence all cell phones and other electronic devices at this time. Thank you. Good afternoon, and welcome to historic Joint Base Myer, Henderson Hall. Originally established as Fort Whipple in 1863, and changed to Joint Base Myer, Henderson Hall in 2009. Its main purpose was fortification in the defense of Washington. Since its inception, Joint Base Myer, Henderson Hall has been the home of horse cavalry, artillery, and infantry. Today, it is home to the Old Guard, the United States Army Band, and the United States Army Garrison. Before today's review begins, the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone, presents a pre-ceremonial concert featuring the following musical selections: Temp Regiment March and Army Strong.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, your United States Army Band. Once again, good afternoon and welcome. Today, the United States Army Military District of Washington, represented by the soldiers of the 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard, and the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone, pay a special tribute to several soldiers who are retiring after many years of distinguished service to the United States Army and our nation. Participating in today's review, from left to right, is the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone. Formed in 1922 by then Army Chief of Staff, General John J. Pershing, the United States Army Band is the premier band of our senior service. Pershing Zone provides musical support for ceremonies and special events in our nation's capital and throughout the United States. The United States Army Band is under the direction of Lieutenant Colonel Randy Bartell and led by Drum Major Ben Cadel. Elements of the Old Guard include Honor Guard Company, commanded by 1st Lieutenant Ethan Blackie and led by Staff Sergeant Michael Wolf. Next online is Delta Company, commanded by 1st Lieutenant Randall Hahn and led by Staff Sergeant Jeremiah Ruthie. Next online is Bravo Company, commanded by 1st Lieutenant Justin Michener and led by Staff Sergeant Christian Hyatt. Following is the Commander-in-Chief's Guard, patterned after the unit created by General George Washington in 1776 to be his personal guard. The Commander-in-Chief's Guard is commanded by 1st Lieutenant Garrett Dunn and led by Staff Sergeant Tyler McKay. The last element online, dressed in the Continental Musicians uniform, is the United States Army Old Guard Fife and Drum Corps. During the American Revolution, musicians wore the reverse colors of their parent infantry unit. The men and women of the United States Army Old Guard Fife and Drum Corps maintained this tradition by wearing red coats instead of the infantry blue. The Corps is led today by Drum Major Barrett Newman. Ladies and gentlemen, moving into position is the commander of troops for today's ceremony, Lieutenant Colonel Charles F. Wall, 1st Battalion, 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard. Since the days of the American Revolution, the colors have been one of the most important elements of a military unit. Therefore, taking the center of our formation in just a moment and bearing the national color is the nation's foremost color team, the 3rd Infantry's Continental Color Guard, led by Staff Sergeant Zachary Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advancing of the colors. Please be seated. The history of the 3rd United States Infantry Regiment reflects the growth and development of our nation. 55 well-earned battle streamers, 2 valorous unit awards, 3 meritorious unit commendations, and 5 superior unit awards attest to the Old Guard's record of bravery in action and achievements during peacetime. In 1922, the War Department granted permission for the Old Guard to pass in review with bayonets fixed. The Old Guard will now fix bayonets to the traditional beat of the drum. Ladies and gentlemen, taking the reviewing stand are the reviewing officials for today's ceremony. Colonel John Egan, Chief Warrant Officer 4, Fabian Flores, and Command Sergeant Major Renard Chaffin, accompanied by the hosts, Major General Trevor J. Bradenkamp, Commanding General, Joint Task Force National Capital Region, Military District of Washington, and Command Sergeant Major Nicholas P. Rocky, Command Sergeant Major, 1st Battalion, 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advancing of the colors and remain standing for the United States National Anthem. Please be seated. Major General Bredenkamp and Command Sergeant Major Rocky are now moving into position to honor the retirees. Please feel free to applaud your soldier as they are called. Headquarters Department of the Army Special Orders. By order of the Secretary of the Army, the following soldiers of the Department of the Army are retired. Colonel John F. Egan, Aviation. Chief Warrant Officer 4, Fabian Flores, Military Intelligence. Command Sergeant Major Renard Chaffin, Air Defense. Colonel Jonathan E. Allen, Logistics. Colonel Michelle L. Bienes, Military Intelligence. Colonel Paul A. Henry, Finance Corps. Colonel Herman L. Johnson, Jr., Logistics. Colonel Stephen J. Rupel Lee, Infantry. Colonel Victor A. Suarez, Medical Services. Lieutenant Colonel Jeffrey C. Franklin, Corps of Engineers. Lieutenant Colonel Joshua L. Kessler, Judge Advocate General Corps. Lieutenant Colonel Norman E. Morris, Army Nurse. Lieutenant Colonel Laura L. Wong, Medical Services. Major Takethia C. Brown, Signal Corps. Major Philip E. Burris, Finance Corps. Major Scott J. Koritz, Logistics. Major Vernon D. Taylor, Logistics. Chief Warrant Officer 4, John E. Rowley, Signal Corps. Warrant Officer 3, Rodney G. Little, Military Police. Sergeant Major Michael W. Ryan, Chemical. First Sergeant Jerry L. Gunquanko, Medical Services. Master Sergeant Alton M. Godbolt, Signal Corps. Master Sergeant Bruce T. Terman, Culinary Specialist. Sergeant First Class Emilio L. Betancourt, Supply Specialist. Sergeant First Class Oyanirin B. Fatinikun, Medical Services. Sergeant First Class Shambhala F. Roach, Adjutant General. Sergeant First Class Anthony P. Herrera, Quartermaster. Sergeant First Class Erica C. Mena, Criminal Investigation Special Agent. Sergeant First Class LaShawn A. Moore, Signal Corps. Sergeant First Class Stephanie B. Smith, Adjutant General. Sergeant First Class Jorge A. Roman, Ordnance. Sergeant Michael A. Johnson, Petroleum Supply Specialist. We are proud to recognize these soldiers' devotion to our country, and we wish them happiness and prosperity in their well-earned retirement. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the posting of the colors. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, Major General Bredenkamp.
Well, good afternoon. It sounds like you were getting a little warmed up there towards the end, so it's a great day to be here at Fort Myer. Distinguished guests, senior leaders, command sergeants, majors, friends, and above all, soldiers and families to be honored today. Thanks for making the time to be here at historic Joint Base Myer-Henderson Hall. On behalf of the Secretary of the Army, Secretary Christine Wormuth, the Chief of Staff of the Army, General Randy George, and the Sergeant Major of the Army, Sergeant Major Mike Weimer, welcome. It's another beautiful day here in the National Capital Region, and really a great day to be a soldier. Before I address our distinguished retirees and families, I'd like to take a special moment to thank those who worked hard to make today such a wonderful occasion. On the floor in front of you are the soldiers of the 3rd U.S. Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard, the Army's oldest active duty infantry regiment. You look tremendous, and your professionalism and precision honors those retiring today. Thanks for your hard work and dedication, and thanks for serving in our Army. Thanks also to the members of the U.S. Army Band, Pershing Zone. As always, you look and sound amazing and make these ceremonies all the more special. Again, please, a round of applause for Pershing Zone. So the soldiers retiring here today joined the Army to be all they could be. Some joined the Army following Desert Shield and Desert Storm. Others after America was attacked on 9/11. All have stood ready to meet the challenges and uncertainties of the global war on terror that brought almost two decades of continuous conflict and combat operations. They stand here today representing the best of America. Today we honor 32 soldiers and their families for their faithful and dedicated service to our nation and for being all they could be. Collectively, these soldiers represent more than 800 years of military service. 800 years. That's pretty impressive. With service around the globe and in a variety of combat arms, combat support, and combat service support specialties, these soldiers, leaders, and their families answered our nation's call and have not only served during a period of persistent conflict, but also trained our young men and women to deploy into harm's way and do our nation's bidding. Our Army and our nation owes you a debt of gratitude and for your service and sacrifice that can never fully be repaid. The medal and the U.S. flag are but a small token of appreciation for your service. I would like to take just a moment to talk about our flag, Old Glory. That you receive a flag on the occasion of your retirement is significant in that it is the symbol of our nation and recognized around the world. We have fought to protect the freedoms in our way of life, and we wear the stars and stripes proudly on our uniform, both here and abroad. The red color in the flag symbolizes hardiness and valor, which each of you has personified as a soldier and leader in our Army, operating in austere conditions with limited resources to accomplish difficult missions. The white color refers to purity and innocence, which you have sought to protect, both here at home and abroad. And the blue represents vigilance, perseverance, and justice, which each of you has demonstrated in the conduct of your duties as officers and non-commissioned officers. I'm sure the flag holds special meaning for each one of you, as it should, given your service to our nation. So as you walk out of Conmy Hall today, take solace knowing you leave behind a legacy of excellence that lives on in the countless soldiers you have trained, mentored, and inspired. The Army is better because of your service. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause for these 32 soldiers. I'd be remiss today if I didn't take some time to thank the family members of each of these retiring soldiers. Your sacrifice and support over the past 20 plus years of service has been foundational to the success of each of these retirees, allowing them to accomplish their assigned missions and serve in the Army that they love. You have remained steadfast in your support during a time of war that necessitated family separations, and for that, you will never be adequately compensated. Please accept our eternal thanks on behalf of a grateful nation for all that you have endured as military families. We could not fulfill our obligations to our soldiers, the Army, and the nation without the love and support of our families. So please join me in a round of applause for all of our families here today. To our retiring soldiers, thank you for your service. You are warriors and soldier for life. So I humbly ask that you take on one last task. Tell the Army story. Help to maintain our all-volunteer Army by sharing your experiences with America's sons and daughters so they might be inspired to follow in your footsteps and volunteer to support and defend the Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic. We continue to serve as a shining example around the world because men and women like you have volunteered to serve. So again, on behalf of Secretary Warmoth, General George, Sergeant Major of the Army Weimer, the Joint Task Force National Capital Region Military District of Washington, and the United States Army, and a proud and grateful nation, thank you. Good luck and Godspeed. Heed the Guardian, this will defend, and be all you can be.
Guard. Attention.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Army Song. The United States Army is honored to have presented today's special ceremony. Thank you for attending and enjoy the rest of your day.